Stage two of the 2013 Santos Tour Down Under starts here in Mount Barker, Pat. First time that this has started in Mount Barker. Also the first time it's finished at Rostrevor. First time also up Corkscrew Road, which will be amazing.
Having ridden all these roads many times before, having ridden Corkscrew probably over 100 times before, it's only around 3 kilometres in length, but they have really steep pitches in it. I reckon it's going to be a really exciting stage for the cycling fans.
So for this particular stage, spectators can come here to the beginning, really enjoy the start here at Mount Barker, and then they've got a couple of options of going across to Echunga for the sprint, or perhaps over to Harndorf where the cyclists come through twice. And then there's really a decision to be made, Pat, whether they go up the Corkscrew and set themselves up there so that they really get to see that last climb before the riders descend down into Rostrevor, or in fact go to Rostrevor to see the finish. You won't have time to do both, so make that decision, be happy with it, and really enjoy the stage today.
The sprint at Echunga, just be a normality. I expect the nature of the course, the windy roads, undulating, you're out of sight very quickly. I expect the breakaway to be away.
So Harndorf, of course, a very favourite tourist spot here in the hills of Adelaide. Fantastic cuisine here, Pat. There's many wares to buy, so it's a really great spot to get here. If you want to set up here, it's magnificent. And of course, we've got a magnificent event coming through, twice through here at Harndorf.
At Harndorf, I expect the peloton to be lined out, chasing an early breakaway, because it's a perfect breakaway day.
So the riders come from Balhanna, through Woodside, up Tears Road to Lenswood, and then they come up the back of Fox Creek Road, Pat, which the riders again haven't done before, certainly done Fox Creek Road from the other direction before, through the beautiful Gorge Road that has undulations, but it's generally downhill into the turn into Corkscrew Road.
What's going to be interesting for me is I've ridden down Gorge Road probably several hundred times in my life, and our training, you could easily reach speeds of 70 kilometres per hour. So, you know, the Pro Tour peloton coming through Gorge Road, they could be reaching 90, 95 kilometres per hour. They'll have a train on the front of the peloton setting the pace at 100%. It'll be as if the finish line is drawn before Corkscrew, because each team will want to have their best climber in the best possible position. Four or five riders per team will sacrifice themselves in a sort of team time trial, 100% to the bottom of Corkscrew, so you can imagine speeds of well over 45, and then I hit a climb, this Corkscrew climb, and as it's almost near the finish, it will be the breaking point for the Tour Down Under. This is today, could be where we see the general classification get shaken up. If you're a spectator, this is the place to be.
And for spectators, the King of the Mountain is right at the top of Corkscrew Road, right at the junction of Corkscrew and Montacute before they turn right and head down into Rostrevor. Pat, here we are at Rostrevor, the Campbelltown Council offices, the finish line of this second stage of the Santos Tour Down Under.
If they have a 10-20 second gap on the small group, actually what we noticed just descending just then, we had quite a headwind. So you're in a gully, in the sort of a little valley there. You're going downhill, but you're actually having to pedal pretty hard to keep speeds. It's going to be a very exciting day, maybe one of the most exciting stages. And Mike Turter's done a terrific job to find something spectacular again.
So on this flat stretch of road here, we can imagine that the road will certainly be closed off. It'll be an excellent place to see the, as you say, Pat, the 2K sprint literally into the finish here opposite the council offices. An excellent place to see the end of this stage.